जी संस्कार, सम नंबर वन दैट इज 12.1, वी हैव इट इज आस्क्ड दैट यू हैव अ वेव विच हैज फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ 2 kHz, वी विल कन्वर्ट इट इन टू हर्ट्स जस्ट सिंपली मल्टीप्लाइंग बाय 1000. लेमडा इज 35 cm, वी विल कन्वर्ट इट इन टू meters, that should be divided by 100 to convert it into meters. Next is distance, which is 1.5 kilometers. 1.5 multiplied by 1000 will give us the distance. What is time required for it? So what we will do, velocity is nothing but lambda divided by time. What is lambda? Lambda is 35 divided by 100. What is frequency nu? Nu is equal to 2000. We will multiply these two. 35 twos are 70. Okay, 32s are 60, so 35 twos are 70, and one more zero, so 700 meter per second. Then velocity is equal to distance upon time. That means if we want to calculate time, then time is equal to distance upon velocity. So distance is 1500 divided by 700. So double zero are going to cancel each other, and the time for this traveling 1.5 kilometer is 2.1 second. Okay, next topic is intensity of sound. How can we define intensity? So intensity is what? The amount of energy passing through a unit area is called intensity of a sound. Two different sound could have same intensity. We sometimes mistakenly or by unconsciously we say loudness and intensity are same, but loudness is different. How loudness is different? Because loudness is a measure of our ear's response towards that sound. If it is strong, we will say the sound is loud, and if it is less, then we will say it is soft. But intensity is what? The amount of energy passing through unit area. So we should not confuse between intensity of sound and the loudness of a sound. Two sound which are exactly equal in intensity could feel loud or soft to you because your ear responds that way. Next is speed of sound in different media. So the speed of sound depends on the medium, how denser the medium is. For example, if you have solid, the frequency of sound would be more. If you have liquid, sound frequency of sound would be lesser. And if you have gaseous medium, then frequency of sound is least. So different media, there is a different frequency or different speed of sound to travel through it. In air at 0 degrees Celsius, this frequency of sound is 331 meter per second, while at 22 degrees Celsius it is 344 meter per second. So you have already given a chart over there in your textbook. So see that chart. Solid, in solid speed is highest, next comes liquid, and then comes gaseous. So one MCQ can be asked, in which material, solid, liquid or gaseous, the speed of sound is highest. Highest is solid and lowest is gaseous. Reflection of sound, let's just understand this particular phenomena which is called reflection of sound. What, like light, sound waves also get reflected, but we have never studied refraction of sound, reflection of sounds or something like that. But why there is a reflection of sound? So basically it is explained very easily, like the law of reflection is followed by sound also. So to check or demonstrate it, let's perform an activity. According to this activity, you are supposed to put a table across a wall. And now I have placed over here an alarm clock which is ringing continuously. I'm supposed to newspaper nahi healthy, ke thick paper nahi healthy. I will make something like this, cylindrical shape, okay? Then I will put it at some angle over here. I can measure it to be 45 degrees Celsius, and I can put that chart paper over here, over there. To secure it, I can use cello tips So I can put it this clock over here also, then also I can hear the sound over here. So this kind of variation can be done. Over here if I have put it, I will hear the same kind of sound both the position. If I have put it over here, I will listen the sound. Sound will get hit the wall and then it gets back and I will listen the sound over here with the same frequency. This time I have put it alarm clock over here. So this is called reflection of sound. Sound waves goes to hits a rigid support and then it comes back and makes the same angle to the normal to the plane at that point of incidence. Next is echo. So if you have ever visited a place which is mountainous like that, you will see echo. What is echo? If you say Nikita, then you will listen Nikita again. So this is echo. If you are speaking, you will feel that somebody from other side is repeating you. This particular event is called echo. There are certain places where you can listen. Basically, these places are mountainous. Next is reverberation. Reverberation is if I will say Nikita, then I will continuously listen Nikita, Nikita, Nikita on something like noise around me. This happens in a newly formed house or construction site, a place which are more empty. So in that particular positions or that particular places, we hear this reverberation. Reverberation is beneficial in no way, but it is very harmful. For example, when town hall is there, when there is a very big hall or gathering, in that particular case, this reverberation creates more sound reflection. It is a basically a kind of reflection of sound, but reflection of sound in multiple times. So that creates noise into one person's head. So theaters, multiplex, also all these places has this multiple reflection of sound, which sometimes is not good for these examples. So always a care is taken to reduce this reverberation. Different thing like echo, that is only one time if we are listening our sound, we will be happy. Okay, but if there is a reverberation, that is not pleasant to our ear. And that's all for now. Thank you.